So let's start talking about how the OpenAPI specification can actually help you in your design. So designing is important because designing an API, even before anything is started, actually forces you to think about a couple of things. Right? One is, you know, it's very important to start thinking about what is your business's taxonomy. It's not a technology thing, right? Remember, like we're moving away from a data-driven approach to a more consumer-friendly, consumer-focused, business-friendly approach. So we need to understand what is the organization's business taxonomy. What do I mean by this? Well, let's take for example, if you are a payment provider, like say PayPal or Braintree, right? In that case, your business taxonomy is looking at all the different bounds of your various services within your technological infrastructure that tie to a specific business. So you will have, say for example, an invoicing feature service. You will have a client ID service. You will have a credit card service. All of these different things are the bounds of your business taxonomy. And so now when you start thinking about, well, okay, this is my business taxonomy. Now I have to create a new API. Instead of going in and developing it further, designing the interface actually forces you to think, well, what are the different resources which I'm going to be exposing that touches on different aspects of my business taxonomy? And then you can actually start, you'll start to understand the intricate ways in which there are relationships that form between these different systems. So once you've identified this, you actually start to think about how can this API bring tangible outcomes to my internal processes? What is the tangible outcome it provides to business? And finally, what is the tangible outcome it provides to customers? Designing the interface actually forces you to do all of these different things. And that's a great thing to do because at the end of the day, remember, your APIs drive your internal and external strategy. So this is an example of a design, right? This is in OpenAPI 2.0 or Swagger 2.0. And over here, notice that this is the designed API and there's no code involved in this. It actually just talks about what is the API description, what is the high level information you can provide for this API, what are the various requests associated with it, and finally, what is the responses for every single for the operation over here. Right, so it's a simple design. Of course, this is just a simple API example. But as your API becomes more complex, as you add more resources, designing the interface becomes a little more challenging, but also leads to long-term positive ramifications. The other big advantage of designing is that it keeps all the internal stakeholders aligned, right? So if, say, for example, the green bar you see on the screen is the design of the API or the RESTful interface, as we want to call it, you will actually see that this actually keeps all of the internal stakeholders, from the testers and the developers and the architects and technical writers, all of them aligned and in sync on what the API does. Because remember, the contract defines what the API is. It talks about the requests, the responses for every single resource. And so there's no second question. There's no big questions in people's minds. They know what this API does. So it keeps all of them in sync and helps actually communicate, and helps actually communicate the value of the API to the stakeholders as well. So a real life example is PayPal. PayPal actually has a system in place internally where they actually go through a stringent review process whenever you're building a new API. They first start with, anytime someone wants to create a new API, they go through an alignment exercise where they look at the business taxonomy and they determine where the API fits into that. Then all the different internal stakeholders have to sign off on that. After which they go about designing the API first. So they design the API interface, and only then, once you've again verified the design with all the technology stakeholders, only then do you actually develop and deploy it. And this is something which is used by PayPal.